This is a small farm kasi ang operation nito is not the typical farm. We're producing two particular products lang, chicken and eggs. But these are serving the niche market since 2011.
Oh, tagal na.
Yeah, kasi I started really na walang market eh. So because my profession is information technology security. So I've been in the IT industry for like 30 years. And then I decided to file an early retirement during pandemic 2020 at College of St. Benilde. So I was with Benilde for 20 years.
Nagtuturo ko, sir?
IT manager sa school. And then we also do part-time teaching kasi I have a master's degree. So we teach particular subject nung specialization.
Oh, okay.
So that's our ano yung isang ginagawa namin sa school. But during pandemic, nung medyo nag-lockdown na, I decided to go full-time sa farm. I should have done it as early as 2012.
Okay, Sir Umber, anong pangalan ng farm ninyo?
My farm, our farm's name is Batangas Free Range Chicken Farm.
Oh.
So well, it's really unique because it's not a normal chicken farm na makikita mong nakakulong yung mga chicken. So we're doing free-range chicken farming that we started as early as 2011.
Available na po ang Agribusiness merch sa Shopee. Ang link na sa description box. Introducing ang iba pang mga special guest speakers para sa Agribusiness Grand Meet and Greet. William Tiu Lim, ang founder ng Mega Prime Foods, ang gumagawa ng Mega Sardines. Jomar Hizon ng Pampangas Best, home of original tusino. Open pa ang early bird promo. Don't forget to register. Strictly no walk-in. Kita-kita po tayo sa August 18, 2024 sa Gazebo Royal sa Quezon City.
That time, walang nakakakilala ng brown egg and brown chicken sa market.
At that time.
We're even ahead of the big commercial companies na nag-start. So, that time, we have already a vision kung ano yung mangyayari na ako in particular na gusto ko. I'm still employed that time. Nag-file ako ng resignation pero it was not accepted that time. So I have no choice. But I always kept on my mind na I need to look for a greener pasture all the time because my kids were small then. So I moved to Singapore for a while because at school we're allowed to work for other company, even employed kami. So we call it a parang sabbatical leave. So we're allowed for a one-year leave to work outside and then go back. So just to break the monotony of your work. But when I was in abroad, I was employed at IBM. I realized na wala na akong buhay pag weekend. I cannot afford not to have a weekend for myself. Like I'm an outdoor person eh. So I bike, I run, I swim. So those things were taken off dun sa work ko. And I realized that I really cannot afford it. So I decided I need to go back to the Philippines work, but I need something na will compensate ko ano yung iniwanan ko. So, and then I thought na I have my favorite thing to do is growing chicken. Kasi I have something in mind na agriculture na eh. The question is, ano yung gusto ko? And my passion until now is chicken. So Sabi ko, I need to do chicken farming, pero ano yung walang gumagawa pa na iba?
Mm-mm.
So that's what excites me from that time on. And then I paid certain seminars to really validate my idea.
Mm.
So I met Robert Kiyosaki that time. And he told me, sabi niya,
you met him?
Yeah, personally.
Wow.
I paid well, it's kind of big amount of money to meet him personal, one-on-one.
Sa Hawaii or sa US?
No. Twice kasi. He was in Singapore and then back in the Philippines. I also met him here in the Philippines.
Okay.
But he's with a group of different billionaires.
Mm.
So, nung iniisip ko na yung nasa mind ko na chicken farming, when I sat down with him, sabi niya, Emer, you have to think of something that you love doing since you were a kid. And then, para akong kinuryente kasi that's exactly what I have in mind. Mm-hmm. Chicken farming. I just have a problem deciding on it kung anong klase.
Mm.
Think of something that nobody does yet. So, chicken farming ng free range.
Sige, sir. Punta natin.
We can walk here.
BFRC.
BFRC. Kasi, yeah, well, I'll share you something more about BFRC kasi I was able to develop other things out of BFRC. Eh.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's really, it's a journey with so many hurdles because it's agriculture.
Mm.
So, given the chance nga, sabi ko nga sa mga iba, given the chance na wala akong kliyente na dependent sa amin, I should have been doing trading na lang eh. Medyo madulas po ha, may ingat ng konti.
Job. Anong year ka umalis sa Binil?
Pagpasok ng pandemic, 2020.
Mm.
Medyo sobrang tight na lang . Sobrang pressure na .
Yung dalawang anak ko doon graduate.
Ah, anong year?
Anong year ba sila?
Multimedia.
Multimedia yung panganay ko.
Okay.
Fashion design yung pangalawa.
So lahat ng mga faculty nila kaibigan ko, sina Bunny Puente. Fashion design, I think sina the Indian faculty.
Hindi ko kilala yung mga nila .
Yan yung mga, we have a very good fashion design and kasi mga unique yung course na yan .
Magastos ha?
Magastos. Even sa film, si Direct Joey Reyes.
Mm.
Medyo sobrang gastos talaga. Buti na lang yung mga anak ko, libre. privilege. Dito ako nag-work.
How big is the farm? Ilang
this
hectares?
This is 1 hectare lang .
Talaga?
Pero the other one kasi is I'm renting also.
Mm.
So that's the bulk of the production. I'm renting it for certain amount din naman. That's 2 hectare. But I have our own naman, 1 hectare din sa kabilang side. Hindi lang
hiwalay.
Hindi lang namin magamit because this area is protected . So the mindset or the rule of the government is if you place in a protected area, you can do chicken farming. Kasi all they know when it comes to chicken farming is the conventional na mabaho, madumi. So hindi pinapayagan.
Bakit protected to?
Because of the lake. So there is a group, there is a management board that is called Protected Area Management Board. So sila yung nag-a-approve ng lahat ng mga agricultural activities dito sa area. Water, sir, at least for now.
May water ako, diba?
Yeah.
And I have coffee. Mamaya tayo kumain.
Anong klaseng brown chicken yung
for the longest time we've been using the line that is called DeKalb.
Mm.
So it's DeKalb line. It is particularly used for egg production. And then for the meat, we use another line na initially we use Hubbard, the brown. But these are all coming from commercial companies.
Mm.
So, I've seen it. Longer time, it cannot be sustainable for us. Eh. So, since pandemic, I focus a research of my own to a local brand of chicken.
Local?
Yes. That's going to be sustainable kasi it's local. So, we don't have to rely on imported ones later on. Yeah, exactly. Example are this type of chicken. These are native from Batangas. We call it Banaba. So it's been here for centuries.
Okay.
That nobody focuses on producing it on a different level or
kaninong
a higher
technology?
Level.
Kaninong technology?
I have. There is a farm here that produces a pure line. Now I frequent at UPLB weekly to coordinate with the expert in at UPLB. So,
sino yung expert?
There are people from Picard and the animal science team. But I think yun nga yung sinasabi ko, this is the future for us. Kasi if you will notice,
sinong nag-ano ng word na banaba?
Yung banaba when I read the history of it, ang mga tatanda pa sa una, they called it banabana. So, hindi pa tapos yung research ko about its full history.
Mm.
But when I look at the characteristics, some people attempted to breed it, pero never nilang naisip that it can be a promising source of our local meat.
Mm-mm.
We just need to do it seriously.
Okay, ako lang natatanong, sir, kasi like... In Guimaras, meron silang darag. In Zamboanga, they have Zampen.
Palawan, you have the Parawakan.
Oo, tapos. So, meron din sa Pangasinan, sa Bulinaw, I don't know what they call it. So, yung sinasabi mo, Banaba is for Batangas.
Yes. When you hear about Banaba, it's a local sa Batangas lang.
Mm-mm. So may purification ano na yan.
Yes, yes. So ako, during the pandemic na 2 years, I stayed here. I studied everything about it from hatching until slaughter age, etc. I documented everything. So now, we're ready. We're just finishing the packaging. Kasi I got tired of imported materials eh. So I kept on thinking na if these people are exporting to us, why can't we do exporting ours then? Di ba? So it's somehow a big target. It will require a lot of resources, but I think starting it now, as early as now, will put us on a different level in the years to come. So for me, that's very sustainable. It will not only support the local community. Kasi the business model that I have here is, if you will notice, we have a very small property. So, we expand our production using the community. So, meaning, we can provide chicken to the community and then we buy everything back. So, that will save you money in terms of your own capitalization. So that's one model that we worked on. You can also build a livelihood out of it. It has to be well managed. There are ups and downs, and sabi ko nga, that's part of it. Most important thing is you have to learn from every setbacks or failure. Not exactly failures, because the way I always say it is, we only discovered so many things that didn't work for us. So yun lang yung katwiran ko from time to time. So we lost a lot of money along the way, but I have to go back for this kind of farming because many people are dependent already on us. For now, if you ask me, there's no such thing as organic, 100% organic chicken in the Philippines. Sad to say that there are businessmen that takes advantage of the word organic and they put it in their own label because that's we are also a victim of these brands.
Well,
so ano that is something that we don't have control naman eh. So we just have to focus on what we are doing, promote what we are doing, and later on time will decide where should this fake brand should be. So yun lang po yung ano, yun lang yung medyo sad part with what we are doing as part of our advocacy. So our egg, it's branded Ala Eggs. Ala Eggs. So I had a dilemma when we were starting na pag-iisip ng brand, kasi everybody kept on asking saan ang galing. So I need to make a baseline in terms of branding. So sabi ko, sige, I'll focus on Batangas. So the brand is Ala Eggs. My second problem is, what does Ala Eggs mean? So took me another 2 weeks to think of alternative agriculture in producing eggs. So that's Ala Eggs. So and then we came to producing our own meat brand naman, which is Alpas, alternative livestock production and systems. So well, I'll show you a sample of the chicken. This is actually the brand that you can find in marketplaces, yung Robinson supermarket. So yeah, this is the brand I developed, and I even put the story at the back. So it's really serving a niche market like Santi's and other high-end stores and even hotel. So our eggs in the supermarket are the only ones with organic ink stamp, because I discovered one time that there are merchandisers swapping the broken eggs to ours. So if you want to put me in jail, you just put some poisoned egg in my tray, and then I'm done. So you have to think of, you have to be security conscious somehow. Kasi I think that's part
saan
of my...
Saan ginawa niyo, sir?
So I imported a stamping device, and I put the our logo here. It's Ala Eggs. And it's organic, certified organic yung ink. It doesn't go through the shell. So, plant-based. So yun yung naisip lang namin to protect the product. Kasi ano yan eh, it adds value to the product, but we didn't actually spend much money doing it. So if consumer can somehow appreciate it, that means that we are really serious about what we are doing to produce their food. So yun lang yung na-discover ko na there is a really difficult situation inside the supermarket when it comes to competition. Kasi nowadays, pag nakakita ang consumer ng brown eggs, they call it organic eggs. No. What makes the organic is the system. Now, for you to determine what kind of eggs you're buying, you have to know the farmer. Kasi when you look at the supermarket gondolas, you'll see lots of brown eggs eh. But they didn't know that most eggs also are caged, just like the whites. And they produce the same brown eggs. But if you ask me, if I just take a look at the egg, this one versus the commercial ones, I can easily determine it. So mabilis ko lang makikita kagad yung totoo at hindi. Kasi that's what
bakit
we do.
Bakit ka pumasok sa supermarket?
Backup market.
Why?
Especially ng when we were starting, I don't have a background about marketing. So we started about 1,000 chicken agad at the time. And my biggest problem is when I was still employed, saan ko ibibenta yung mga eggs at time? Kasi nagpa-pile up sila everyday, trays. Hindi ko sinasabi, binabaon ko na lang kasi nabubulok. But I was just too excited about it. My enthusiasm was too high na I already saw kung ano yung kung saan ko siya dadalhin. So, I need to get experience how to market the produce. So, I joined a networking company for like 3 months to four just to learn marketing. And the first client that we had, in my pipeline is Amanpulo, the hotel in Palawan, the resort in Palawan. So until now, they are still our client for eggs. Kasi that's the most expensive that time, 2011, 2012. So we're happy to say that until now, they're still our client. So down the line, we didn't have a hard time explaining that these are quality produce because these are being used by this client. Now, along the way, I need to think of more and more clients. Mm. Now, we experience a very, very bad production when a big typhoon hits us and everything was swept away.
Mm.
And that's the time that we realized na kailangan namin ng backup market. Except the regular client na communities.
Paano mo ina-handle yung supermarket? Kasi alam naman natin yung supermarket, it needs, paano ba yan? They requires you volume?
No, two things. Number one, we have to pick supermarkets that are high-end or located in some high-end locations.
So not all branches?
Not all branches. The supermarket will give us branches that they identified as high-end. Like for Robinson's, we have the Nuvali, the Galleria, and sort of things. So, yun yung mga ina-identify nila. So, it really helped us, especially during pandemic, kasi nung pandemic, most backyard farms, they didn't create a backup market just like what we did. Wala silang business registration.
Mm.
They just serve their friends, their families. Nung pandemic, walang makalabas. Kami yung nahirapan na mag-supply sa supermarket every day. So, yun yung realization ko na that's the backup market really helped us a lot the time. So, until now, we still develop...
Parang baligtad yan, yung kasi most of the stories na naririnig natin during the pandemic, ang backup nila ay yung community. Neighborhood, yung community. Yes. But in your case, sinasabi mo, it's the other way around.
It's the other way around. Kasi we have lots of production na, number one, nabebenta naman locally.
Mm.
The problem is, you really have to make the price lower.
Mm-mm.
Kasi hindi naman siya ka-price ng regular na eggs and chicken.
Mm-mm.
But nung naipapasok mo siya sa supermarket and the special market, high end naman yung client.
Mm-mm.
So
how many supermarkets you
to date?
We have
Robinson's and the marketplace for chicken. Makati Supermart in Alabang.
Okay.
We have Santis Delicacen and hotels. We cater also the group, the Resorts World, now in Newport Resort.
So how big is your production if you have a lot of markets?
Last year, we have about mga 3,000 heads of chicken hinahati-hati namin sa mga clients. But since early last year until now, nagkaroon ng problem yung supply ng chicken for us, especially the layer. So
the native,
no, yung chicken? Brown panadikal na sinasabi ko. So for almost 2 years, yun yung naging dilemma ng halos lahat, and we're part of it.
That's the reason why you wanted to develop yung native chicken.
Ini-start ko yun nung pandemic, end of, hanggang 2022, I was able to finalize it. So, now ang plan na lang is yung production
nito. Anong naging problem mo in using the cold? Supply ba?
Supply.
The chicks?
Yes.
Hindi consistent?
No, hindi talaga. And even the broiler. So, the problem is, since you don't own the breeders,
yeah.
Kasi we don't breed, kasi our core competency is production lang.
Exactly.
So, I don't focus on breeding. That's a different set of business.
So, yung supplier mo ng chicks hindi consistent?
Yeah, they stop.
They stop because?
Siguro, hindi rin nila ma-push lahat ng production. Since this is...
Locally, ano na yan? Locally, locally produced na yung locally chicks. Produce,
Problem naman with the broiler or the meat is you have an agreed allocation. Mm. Since you're a small farmer and then may dumating na malaking allocation requirement from them, isi-swing nila dun sa mas malaki. Mm. So, walang useless yung agreement ninyo if you're just a simple farmer na ganun. So,
yeah, it always happens.
It always happens. So, sabi ko nga, kung wala kang control, you can't do anything about it. Kaya nga, okay, we need to establish our own control by focusing on the local.
Pero if you have the market, if you have the market, it's not, hindi ba siya right thing to do na you have your own breeding? If you have the market,
yes,
just to sustain the market you have.
Exactly. That should be the direction na tatahakin mo eh. Mm. Now, it requires additional big capitalization for the breeding alone.
Okay.
You have to put up another company facility for that or facility or you need to get an investor for that alone.
Yeah, okay.
If you're going to get an investor for that alone, the next question is, how long can you sustain na mabibenta nila lahat yung sisyo na yan all the time, yung excess? Kasi ikaw is just part of the production eh. So there will be more excess na kailangan nilang i-distribute to other farmers consistently because that is a business for them. So medyo hindi kami nakakuha ng may mga ganun nag-breed at a time pero huminto.
The smaller breeder then na pwede mong kunin lahat.
Yes, pwedeng ganun. We had the plan already. We put up like 2016, we established our own breeders. Mm. And then I have a good friend na taga rito rin. Medyo he just passed away because of an accident. So that's one of our plans. Mm. So I stopped from that point on kasi he's the breeding expert eh.
Okay.
So I didn't pursue. So I go back. Mm. I relied on the existing commercial companies. Until last year, mid of this year, nagkaroon ng problem yung importation ng mga breeders of these big companies. So damay-damay na lahat. Mm-hmm. So
ang daming nagbi-breed, some problem nila market.
Yes.
Ikaw ang problema mo source. Hindi kaya ano lang yun, mismatch of the ano?
I think exactly. Hindi lang nagkakabangga yung mga tamang source at saka market kasi we at this time hindi ako natatakot about the market kasi I've been exposed to the market. Alam ko yung demand nila. Mm. There are even guys who called us na, "Emer, kaya nyo bang mag can ng free-range chicken export?" So, may mga ganung bagay
na... Huwag mo muna yung export because that's another problem. Yun palang local. You have the demand for the local, di ba?
Yes, yes. So, yung local lang... Yung local...
Malaki na.
Malaki na. If you focus only on dito sa mga... Kahit niche market lang,
hindi
mo kaya akapin eh.
Let's say for example, dun sa niche market mo na local... We're talking about how many stores yan? Of Robinson's, of other stores?
Now kasi, ang hawak naming Robinson's, both for chicken and eggs, 50. Yes.
Paano may di-deliver lahat yun, 50?
Yeah, there's a schedule. The only problem is, sa sobrang short nga, I just need to inform them from time to time na we are distributing the amount of supply that we have to different stores. Kasi ang nangyayari dyan, like for example, one store will get 30 trays and so on. Mm. Others will get 50, 70, etc. Mm. Trays of 12 and the basket as well. Mm. So, dinidistribute namin. Ganun ang nangyayari.
Ang nakikita kong problem doon, if you have 50 stores, is the delivery.
The delivery, yes. So,
kasi may oras lang sila ng pagtanggap and you have 50, meaning you will deploy a lot of transportation.
You have to schedule, you have to program the delivery per group of stores in location.
Pero sila kasi nagsasabi kailang magde-deliver eh.
No, sa amin in our case, we monitor the produce pag wala na we deliver.
Okay.
So medyo nabihasa na ako dun sa sistema ng supermarket and I was able to streamline our own processes. So we also partner with delivery services kasi when I look at it, hindi naman ganun
kalaki. Paano yun? Kung partners mo sila, like what? Lalamove, like, ganyan?
Yes. So we prepare everything in our store sa highway.
When
pick up, deliver per store.
Hindi ka matatalo sa cost?
No. Kasi when you book at Lalamove, it will only cost us like, how much? 2,000 peso plus?
Kasi madali lang.
Yes,
kasi
magaan. Yes.
Kaya it's
working. So, mabilisan yung delivery. Robinson has, in our experience, Robinson has the most efficient receiving for me. Ha? Kasi it only takes us about 15 minutes. Sibat ka na eh.
So, depende siguro sa commodity.
Streamlined naman yung when it comes to our egg delivery experience, streamlined. Ngayon, with all these things na ginagawa namin, every day we sit down, iniisip namin kung what's going to be the future. Mm. And then, ito na nga, si Brother Mike, he always tell me things na dapat ganito, ganyan. And I always follow his expert advice as a businessman. So, we also come up of something na we will become a partner dun sa isang produkto. We actually develop a lechon manok brand. I-reveal ko na yung brand. It's Kuya M's. It's Kuya M's.
Maranan?
Kuya M's. It's M and apostrophe S. My surname kasi si Scar.
Okay.
So it's Kuya M's. So yeah.
Maranan si Scar.
So it's a lechon manok na special.
Hindi mo ba pinipre M, sir?
So ano yan? Objective then is to help other people for in this particular business. So
now you will be using the brown chicken.
To start muna, we will be using our what we have, the regular chicken. Then later on, as part of the project, the native chicken will come into play.
Mm-mm.
So that's a long term. A long term. And wala kasing ano eh, we feel that there is always market for what we are doing kasi whenever we develop brands, behind these brands are emotions eh. So that's why yun yung nagpo-propel sa amin to bring it up. So yeah,
Sir Emmer, at present, going back to the egg, ala egg and
alpas.
Okay.
Alpas.
Anong status mo? Short ka sa supply?
Short sa supply.
Short ka.
Yeah.
So mas malaki yung market, yung demand.
Yes. Especially for the chicken. I have my own fear din kasi. The business is a sole proprietorship.
Okay.
I don't have partners.
Okay.
So when I don't have partners, it means it requires my own personal resources all
Correct.
The time.
Uh-oh.
That's
so much slower.
Yes,
movement.
Yes.
Okay.
So kasi nobody's an entrepreneur in the family.
Okay.
So because of my interest in doing this kind of thing, yun lang yung nag-start how I developed this farm or these brands and somehow made me an entrepreneur in a way. Yun yung fear ko lang. So I need to, when I realize that I cannot do it alone, I need to find somebody that will share the same interest to expand it at a different level. So, malaki yung demand, especially for the chicken.
Okay.
There are so many things. Ang pinag-uusapan pa lang natin, whole chicken. Wala pa dyan yung mga cuts.
Wala pa.
So,
is there a demand also for the cuts?
malaki yung demand malaki sa fans. Exactly. So, yun dun ako excited. And then I have discussed this with the DA already. Kasi nga, second problem is, yung technical ng production, okay na eh. But, the dressing itself is another concern.
Yeah.
Kasi when you put these things in the supermarket or high-end hotel, sasabihin sa'yo, asan yung mga NMIS permit
correct,
mo niyan?
Correct. Uh-oh.
So, yung second problem ko na yon, I realized it along the way na ino-offer ko siya. Kasi wala akong idea na ganun pala yun eh. So, naghanap ako ng dressing plant dito sa buong Batangas. Ang dami. Ang problema, walang tumatanggap sa akin. Kasi,
maliit ka masyado.
Magpapakatay ka, 500, 1,000. Pipitikin ka lang eh. Uh-huh. So, sa kahanap ko na ganyan, nakarating ako ng San Pablo, Laguna.
Ang layo.
Ang layo. And I waited to have an appointment with the owner. Nandun ako ng mga 7 o'clock. I think na-entertain ako, mga 11 eh. Eh, maliit na farmer eh. So, nakiusap lang ako ng magpakatay. But after that, since yung owner ng big facility started as a small backyard farm, in-accommodate nila kami until now. So, very thankful to the plant owner herself para i-accommodate yung chicken namin.
Available na po ang Agribusiness merch sa Shopee. Ang link nasa description box. Agribusiness, how it works. Instruct, inspire, succeed.